Good morning, everyone. Our best worthy God for John and my father. Let us pray. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
With the grace and the peace of God, our Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ, be with you all.
Amen. Amen.
As we acknowledge our sinfulness, we prepare ourselves to celebrate these most sacred mysteries. You were sent to deal with the contrite, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Be for us in the right hand of the Father, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us offer to the Father our prayers. Glory to God on highest,
and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we give you glory, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your good glory.
Glory to God. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, Amen, amen, I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains just a grain of wheat. But if it dies, it produces much fruit. Whoever loves his life loses it, and whoever hates his life in this world will preserve it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there also will my servant be. The Father will honor whoever serves me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
celebrate the Feast of St. Lawrence, there's some interesting stories that are always told about him. I think the problem with the most familiar is when he was called in by the Emperor Valerian, and he was told that he had to turn over all of the wealth of the church. And Lawrence just looked at him and said, well, I'll need a couple of days to do that. And what he did was he went back and he took whatever they had that was of value, and he gave it all to the poor, and he distributed it throughout Rome. And then he finally showed up again on the third day, you know, when the emperor was waiting for him and the authorities were waiting for him. But he came with some other people, and he came with the poor, he came with the blind, with the lame, with the lepers. And he walked in with all those people, and he looked at the authorities and the emperor, and he said, these are the treasures of the church. These are the treasures of the church. I wonder how we could get an attitude like that toward our own lives and identify what the real treasures are in our own lives. Oftentimes we get caught up and confused with so many things, and you know, we're always trying to possess more and more and more. And if you really don't, if you don't believe what I'm saying, you just have to look around your house and look at all the things that you've got, you know, kind of stuffed away. And if you think that you're doing really well, then ask yourself, why do we have all these other storage units being built along the way to put our extra stuff there? You know, we want to accumulate all of those things. And it seems as though Lawrence is telling us very simply, and so is St. Paul in his letter to the Corinthians, that it's divesting ourselves of what we have and getting down to just the essentials. So the question I guess that came to my mind was, well, how do you identify who's poor and what does that really all mean? I remember I was only ordained a couple of years, and typically we did, I'm sure we could probably do here at St. Mary's, around Christmas time. You know, you gather, you know, the people, and they bring in presents for, you know, for the poor, you bring them down, maybe you bring them down to Philly, or you bring them to some parish that is less fortunate than we here at St. Mary's. And so we did the same thing in the parish that I was in. We brought a ton of things down to the city of Patterson, down to a parish that's called St. Anthony. It was run by the Franciscan friars. And as we were dropping off all of these presents, I was looking in his bulletin, and I noticed that he had an announcement in the bulletin for his people. And it was to remind them that there would be a collection for the poor. And I looked at him and I said, Father, I said, help me out here. I'm kind of like, you know, kind of confused. I said, didn't we just bring all these things down here because, you know, the families need them and they're trying to take care of their families and their children and all that? I said, and then I see in your bulletin that you're having a collection for the poor and you're asking your people to donate to that. And he said to me, he says, Peter, he says, keep this in mind. He says, there's always someone poorer than you, and you can always be of help to them. We thought we might be doing something for them, but he was doing something even more. And he was telling us that it has nothing to do with what's in my pocket, or maybe even what's stuffed away somewhere. It's an attitude of mind, and especially of heart. And the heart must be a generous giver. That's what Jesus says through St. Paul in today's reading. He says, whoever sows sparingly will reap sparingly. But whoever sows generously will reap generously. He's given us all the gifts. Whatever we have, in a sense, he's always given us enough. Enough to take care of our families, enough to take care of maybe somebody else that we know that's close by. But it's how we sow that determines how we do that and what we have. And if we do it generously, well, then we will reap bountifully. That's not a question of what's in my pocket, but it is a question of whether my heart is of generous giving. Blessed are you, Lord, out of all creation, for through your goodness you have received the bread and offered you, fruit of the earth, bread of human hands, will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, out of all creation, for through your goodness you have received the wine and offered, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual bread.
Blessed be God forever. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen.
For the same as you have informed by my teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called on the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the words and my soul shall be healed. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there also will my servant be, says the Lord.